It's no secret that Regular Show is one of my favorite shows of all time. It's also no secret that one of my least favorite characters in the entire show is Mordecai. But believe it or not, at one point in time, he used to be my favorite character in the entire show. But because of several different moments throughout the series, Mordecai quickly went from being a character that I really used to like to being a character that, honestly, I used to hate at times. And if you've ever seen Regular Show before, it's not really hard to see why. I mean, all my homies hate Mordecai. So about 3 months ago, I put out this video called These Episodes Will Make You Hate Mordecai, where in the video, I basically talked about why my opinions on Mordecai as a character flipped. And I used a couple infamous episodes like Punchies, Rigby's Graduation Day Special, and Dumped at the Altar to really nail in the point on why Mordecai just kind of sucks as a character. And even though there was a lot of people agreeing with me, ever since that video took off, I've been getting non-stop comments of people saying that Rigby has done way worse things than Mordecai and I'm being hypocritical for only making a negative video on Mordecai. Which is kind of crazy because I've already expressed that at one point in time, I hated Rigby as a character for the exact reasons that people were listing. But I'm a fair man, so since I made a whole video on episodes that made me hate Mordecai, today let's take a look at some of the episodes that really made me hate Rigby and why he was my least favorite character in the beginning of Regular Show. Now, it should already be no surprise to anyone that Rigby very early on in Regular Show was a terrible person. I mean, to this day, it genuinely confuses me how he never got fired from the park. Because when you go back and rewatch a lot of the earlier episodes, you realize Rigby was the cause of a majority of the problems. And certain people like to say that this is an exaggeration and Mordecai and Rigby were getting into equal amounts of trouble in the beginning of the show. That is not true. Because while Mordecai and Rigby would both get in trouble for being slackers, Rigby would cause a lot more chaos than Mordecai. Rigby was the one that sold away all the park members' souls for a bowling ball and forced the park members to win them back. When the park was being threatened by an audit and Rigby's brother, out of the kindness of his heart, came to save the day, Rigby was the one that hurt his feelings and made his brother leave crying. Rigby was the one that unleashed man-eating hot dogs at the park barbecue. And not to mention, in the very first episode, The Power, Rigby was the one that sent Skips to the moon, forcing him, Mordecai, Benson, and Pops to go rescue him. And it was incident after incident like this that would really start to make me hate Rigby as a character. But there were a few in particular episodes that really rubbed me a wrong way when it came to Rigby, with one of the first episodes being the infamous episode, It's Time. Now, I said this episode is infamous, but not for the reasons you might think. You see, when people reference this episode, they usually reference it as a negative episode for Mordecai, because in the episode, he would infamously kill Rigby after pushing him off a microwave into space. And a lot of people like to use this as a negative moment for Mordecai, but the thing is, if you actually watch the episode, you know that Rigby was the villain the entire episode. The episode starts off at the coffee shop with Mordecai and Rigby watching the trailer for a movie. Mordecai says that the movie looks awesome, and that's when Rigby mentions that he bought two tickets for the two of them to go see it. But Mordecai turns Rigby down, explaining that he already bought two tickets for another movie that he wants to ask Margaret out on a date to go see. Mordecai then tries to ask Margaret out on the date, but ends up fumbling over his words. And Rigby jumps in, making a joke that ends up making Margaret laugh.
You're gonna have to excuse Mordecai here. He has a hard time trying to espresso himself.
Good one, Rigby.
And it's here that we start to notice that Mordecai is jealous of the fact that Rigby can make Margaret laugh, but he doesn't want to acknowledge it to Rigby. Margaret then comes back with the wrong order for Rigby, and when Rigby asks if everything's alright, she explains that her head's been out of it because she has to move soon. This isn't when Mordecai explains that he can help Margaret move, to which she's ecstatic about, and Rigby, in an attempt to mess with Mordecai, also offers his help. Rigby once again then makes Margaret laugh at a joke, and when Mordecai acts weird about it again, Rigby calls him out for being jealous. We then fast forward to our boys helping Margaret move, and Rigby is once again making Margaret laugh, which is really getting under Mordecai's skin. And when Margaret walks away to go handle something, Mordecai tells Rigby to leave and says that he's ruining his chances with Margaret. But Rigby tells Mordecai that he's the one that's ruining his own chances, and says that Mordecai's not even going to end up asking Margaret out, and that he's going to end up seeing the movie that Rigby wanted to see with him later. Now, up until this point in the episode, if making Margaret laugh to get under Mordecai's skin was the worst thing Rigby did, I wouldn't really be mad at him. Some people might argue that this isn't a bro thing to do, but I would actually argue that this is really how a lot of guy friends act. But what happens next is really why I say Rigby crosses the line, especially when it comes to his best friend.
Margaret, wanna see something cool? Bam! Two tickets to the zombie dinner party premiere! Wanna go with me tonight?
You actually got tickets? Yeah, I'll totally go with you tonight. Mordecai, you gotta come too.
Mordecai can't come because I only got 2 tickets.
And you could just see that this whole interaction is killing Mordecai from the inside. And this whole taking Margaret on a date was just really goofy behavior to me from Rigby, because there was absolutely no purpose for this other than the fact that he just wanted to hurt Mordecai. Other than this one episode, there has never been a moment throughout 8 seasons of regular show where Rigby has done anything to make a move on Margaret or show that he's attracted to her. Hell, even in this episode, you could clearly see that Rigby isn't asking Margaret out because he wants to take her out on a date. He's clearly doing it just because he's getting satisfaction from spiting Mordecai. But the thing that makes it so weird is that he's spiting Mordecai for what? Like, it's obvious that he's mad that Mordecai isn't going to the movies with him, but it's not like Mordecai promised he'd go and bailed at the last minute or something. Rigby tried to surprise Mordecai with tickets, and Mordecai just politely turned down Rigby, saying that he already planned on taking Margaret, the girl that he's been obsessed with since season 1, to the movies. Which, if Rigby actually wanted to be a good friend, he would support Mordecai. But from the way Rigby acts in this episode, you would swear that Mordecai did something crazy to him. Because after asking Margaret out right in front of Mordecai, Rigby then proceeds to rub it in Mordecai's face all throughout the day.
You know what I like best about Margaret? The way she's not going out with this guy! Oh! 2 more hours till my date!
And mind you, all Mordecai did was say that he wasn't going to the movies with Rigby. We then see later in the episode that Mordecai tries to make Rigby miss the day with Margaret by destroying all of the clocks in the house by putting them in the microwave. And in an attempt to get him back, Rigby jumps on Mordecai's back, knocking him into the microwave. This causes the two of them to be teleported through time and space on top of the microwave, and then the two of them get into an argument about whose fault this is.
I just wanted to see zombie dinner party with my bro, who flaked on me for some girl who doesn't even know he exists!
But see, the problem with this statement is, Rigby acts as if he's literally done nothing wrong throughout this entire episode. Rigby frames this whole situation as, oh, I just wanted to go to the movies with my best friend, and all of this is Mordecai's fault because he was jealous for no reason. But in all actuality, after Mordecai turned down going to the movies with Rigby, Rigby, number one, flirts with a girl that Mordecai likes multiple different times, knowing that Mordecai doesn't like it. Number two, asks the girl that Mordecai likes on a date, even though Rigby doesn't like the girl and is only doing get to mess with Mordecai. And number three, rubs in the fact that he's taking Margaret out on a date in front of Mordecai's face for the entire day. So for Rigby to frame this whole situation as, oh, I just wanted to go see a movie with my friend and he flaked on me, is crazy, especially when Mordecai never said he was going to see the movie with Rigby. And in real life, if Rigby had did any of this to anyone, nobody would want to be friends with him. And the part to me that's so confusing about this episode is that it really tries to downplay how bad Rigby was in this episode. After Mordecai pushes Rigby off the microwave, he meets Father Time. And Father Time tells Mordecai that Rigby's dead, Mordecai's stuck with him for eternity, and he tells Mordecai that it's all his fault and it's because of his petty jealousy. He then proceeds to show Mordecai all the moments of him being jealous from earlier in the episode. And Mordecai would go on to say this.
It's true, I am jealous of Rigby, and even though he's annoying, he's still my best friend. You're right, Father Time. I deserve to be trapped here.
The only problem is, this is a terrible takeaway. Father Time framing Mordecai's actions as just petty jealousness is wild. I would be willing to bet 9 out of 10 times that if somebody's best friend, their best friend in the entire world, was acting the way Rigby was acting in this episode towards their crush, they would act exactly like Mordecai. And you could actually argue for a majority of the episode that Mordecai was pretty calm, he never freaked out or really put his hands on Rigby. Most of the stuff that Rigby was doing, Mordecai just took and ate it. And even if we go back to when he pushed Rigby off of the microwave, Rigby was the one that pushed Mordecai first. If you slow the episode down and look closely, you could see that Mordecai is dangling off of the microwave. But despite all this, the narrative in the episode is that Mordecai was just a jealous freak for no reason and that he deserves to be in this situation. No he doesn't. And the part that I hate the most about this episode is the ending. Because Father Time eventually sends Mordecai back to earlier in the day at the coffee shop. And we see Mordecai relive the moment where Rigby made Margaret laugh. Rigby then notices that Mordecai's jealous and tells him to admit it. And Mordecai, who first denies it, eventually just says, yeah, he's jealous. But my problem with this ending is not only does it heavily emphasize that all this is apparently Mordecai's fault, but also after watching the entire episode, you see that Rigby didn't get any repercussions for his actions. He died believing that he didn't do anything wrong and that Mordecai was just jealous for no reason. So watching this ending, the only thing I could think about is the fact that if Mordecai hadn't said that he was jealous, Rigby would have just did the same thing all over again. But the crazy thing is, in terms of how Rigby treated Mordecai in the earlier seasons, this is only the second worst episode. because the episode Do Me a Solid is by far the number one episode that made me hate early season Rigby. The episode starts off with Rigby asking Mordecai to do him a solid and get him eliminated. We then go through a montage of the two asking each other to do each other solids, like turning off the TV, handing each other the remote, and cheesing nachos. The two then go to the coffee shop to get some coffee, and while there, Eileen asks Rigby if he would want to go play miniature golf with her after her shift, which Rigby declines.
So, Rigby, I was wondering, do you like miniature golf? Me too!
But trying to save face, Eileen tells Rigby that it wasn't a date or anything and that it could actually be a group thing with her, him, Mordecai, and Margaret. Mordecai then tells Rigby to do him a solid and go to the group thing so that he could get with Margaret. And Rigby, who opposed at first, says that the only way he'll do it is if Mordecai gives him 10 free solids, which, I'm not gonna lie, is low-key crazy.
What? That's ridiculous!
Okay, that's cool. Then I guess you won't mind Mordecai crying yourself to sleep tonight instead of going on a hot date with Margaret.
Ah! Fine, I owe you 10 solids.
We then fast forward to the actual group date, and I can't lie, even though I hated Rigby at this point in the story, he was unintentionally the funniest character.
Yeah, he wants to make it last, because it'll never happen again.
Ow!
Mordecai then tries to get in the passenger seat by Margaret, but that's when Rigby uses his first solid to ask Mordecai to sit in the back with Eileen. Fast forward to the mini golf course and Mordecai starting up a conversation with Margaret. We also get an interaction between Rigby and Eileen.
I just laid sea turtle eggs and now I'm gonna swim out to sea, although many of my hatchlings won't live to adulthood.
Let's just get this over with.
Okay, Rigby was not right for a majority of things in this episode, but why was early season Eileen so weird? Nonetheless, the group date begins and we start to see throughout the episode that Rigby begins to use his 10 solids to sabotage Mordecai and make him look bad in front of Margaret, using his second solid to make Mordecai scream and mess up Margaret's shot, and using his third solid to make Mordecai eat a burrito full of hot sauce that he spits out on Margaret. And look, I understand at this point in the story, Rigby doesn't like Eileen. Don't get me wrong, that sea turtle thing from early in the episode was really weird. But at the end of the day, Mordecai's your best friend that you've known since you were a little kid, your best friend that got you the very job that's sustaining your life right now. And you mean to tell me that you couldn't just stomach it and behave for like, what, 4 hours to make him look good in front of the girl he's been obsessed with since season one? Because throughout the rest of the episode, we would see that Rigby would continue to use the rest of his solids in order to sabotage Mordecai's date, making him ask Margaret for money, making him take the blame for a fart. He would also invite Muscle Man and High Five Ghost over, and I don't know what was going on with Muscle Man in this episode, but he was acting extra weird.
Hey ladies, watch what else I can do with my ice cream sandwich.
Mordecai, I think I'm gonna go soon.
Eventually, Rigby would get down to his last solid, and Mordecai would tell him to just use it before Margaret left. Rigby then proceeds to tell Mordecai to do him a solid, but we don't actually get to hear what it is, but whatever it is, it's so bad that Mordecai calls Rigby insane and tells him that he's not doing it. We then see the floors and the walls of the house begin to split open as Rigby tells Mordecai that this is happening because he's not doing it solid. Skips, Benson, and Pops then pull up, and Skips tells Mordecai and Rigby that they shouldn't have abused the solids, but he tells Mordecai that he needs to do it solid or they're all gonna die, which Mordecai still refuses. But Margaret convinces Mordecai to do it by telling him that she won't look at him any different for doing a solid if it's for a friend, and that's what friends are for. And then Mordecai proceeds to do his solid. And you know, we never actually get told or get to see what this solid is, but ever since this episode came out, fans have speculated online, and if the solid is anywhere near as bad as what people assume it to be, there's no way I would be friends with Rigby. There's no way I would ever be cool with Rigby, especially since he recorded it. And that's really my problem with Rigby throughout this entire episode. He treated Mordecai like trash from start to finish, and then made him do something extremely terrible in front of all his day-to-day people. And then on top of that, Rigby recorded it and had an entire watch party for it. And then once again in this episode, Rigby faces no real consequences for his actions. Because once Rigby realizes that Mordecai is actually mad at him and wants nothing to do with him, which you know is a valid response to what Rigby did, Rigby makes up some kind of lie about how Mordecai asked him to do him a solid and destroy the tape, and then Rigby proceeds to destroy the tape in front of everybody. And then the way the episode frames it, it's just all fine and dandy after that, and Mordecai forgives him and everybody moves on. Bro, you could not have paid me to be friends with Rigby after this. Every time I watch these two episodes, it just brings back all the memories on why I didn't like Rigby. But at least I can say, for as bad as he was, he still went on to become one of the best characters in all of Regular Show. But let me know in the comments, how did you feel about Rigby in these two episodes? And also let me know what other characters and shows I should cover. Also make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and hit the notification bell to be notified when I upload my next video. And it's until then, it's been your boy Corn XV, and I'm off this. I don't need